Okay, your impressions on the budget.
Well, you know, building a sustainable Manitoba requires taxing things that we do not want, like pollution, and removing taxes from things that we do want, from like job creation. Unfortunately, this budget failed to do that. We took a look through the budget. We saw very little in terms of environmental protection. The budget for conservation has been decreased. A $1 million commitment for climate change reductions, while laudable, really fails. It's a pittance in what is needed, especially when we consider that this government has failed to meet their own legislated climate change targets. Only 30% of the conservation and water stewardship budget is dedicated to environmental protection, water stewardship, and biodiversity. We think a larger proportion of that budget should be dedicated towards actually protecting Manitoba's lakes, wildlands, etc. Another thing to note about this budget is we saw nothing in the agriculture budget towards sustainable agriculture. What we think is that to build a sustainable agriculture system means investments in moving towards organic agriculture. We would take subsidies that are going towards pesticide and fossil fuel derived fertilizer, and we put that towards funding a sustainable Manitoba. It's also worth noting that if you look at fuel taxes, they've only increased about 2.8% since 2000 on average. In comparison, other taxes have increased on average 5% per year. What we're saying is the lag in the fuel taxes means that there's not enough money to cover the maintenance of the roadways. We feel that in this context of low fuel prices, that a few cents, more cents per liter could more than fund and cover the maintenance of our roadways, and could also even leave some money left over for better funding public transportation. It's also worth noting when we're talking about budget priorities that when it comes to child and family services, less than only 1.8% per year has been increased in expenditures since 2000, compared to 5% overall increase in expenditures in Manitoba generally. So when we look at the crisis in our child and family services, is it any surprise when we've been systematically underfunding it for a decade and a half? Basically, at the end of the day, what we're looking at is that a green budget needs more than just a green cover. A green budget has to work on greening society at all levels across all sectors.
Was there anything in there for people who are living below the poverty line, as many Manitobans are?
Thank you. Yeah, I should say there's one point to congratulate this government on is they've increased rent assist to 75% of the median level. And that's a step in the right direction. However, Green Party of Manitoba analysis shows that because this is an application-based program, many of the people who are eligible are not in fact getting the benefit to this program. Our numbers estimate maybe 10%. Other programs like the Child Tax Benefit and the 55 Junior Plus credits are similar, that not the entire population is getting benefit to these credits in the population. The Green Party of Manitoba in the coming months will be unveiling a plan that we think is better suited for Manitoba. What we're going to do is remove refundable and non-refundable tax credits and use that to fund a refundable tax credit for those of modest means in Manitoba. So we have plans that we'll be unveiling shortly that we think are better steps in the reduction. Now, I will say it's good to see the government put some attention to the poverty file, but I will say that more attention is needed, and it is interesting that they only have put money towards the poverty file less than a year before the next provincial election.